more beautiful than seeing the sun setting across the horizon. But have you ever thought about what a horizon is? Or where does the sun go? Is it moving? And how does it come back on the opposite side of the sky? And why is there less daytime in the winter? And why is it cold in the winter? Maybe you've wondered about some of these mysteries. Maybe you've already investigated them and know some of the answers. If you have, then you know that they're not mysteries. They're scientific questions, specifically astronomy questions, and they're not mysteries because astronomers have discovered the answers. Today, we are going to go spinning in circles around our amazing sun and uncover facts about the Earth's rotation around its axis and how all this spinning affects us every day and night and day and, well, you'll see. Let's start by introducing the star of our show, the amazing ball of hot plasma, our sun. The sun is the star at the center of our solar system in the Milky Way galaxy. We need our sun for warmth and light, but as you know, every evening the sun sets and it is dark until morning. So what gives? Where does the sun set to? The thing is, the sun doesn't actually set, and in reality, it's always daytime on one side of the planet. This is because the Earth rotates on its own axis. What's an axis? Great question, aspiring astronomers. An axis is an imaginary line about which something rotates. Try this. Imagine poking a long stick through the center of a ball. Holding the stick in one hand, spin the ball with the other hand. In this example, the stick is the axis for the ball. In the same way, the Earth rotates around its axis. This is called the axis of rotation. It takes the Earth 24 hours to rotate around its axis. That is one full day. When one side of the Earth is facing the sun, it is light, or daytime. As the Earth rotates, each new part of the Earth that faces the sun gets light. We call this sunrise. And when the part of the Earth where you are located slowly rotates away from the sun, it becomes nighttime. When this is happening, we call it the sunset. So, that explains night and day, and if you think about it, it even explains the sun setting at the horizon. So, what do you think is happening? If you said that the Earth rotates on its axis away from the sun, then you would be right. It just looks like the sun is moving because we are down here and not in outer space. Okay. So we understand all about the sun's light and how the Earth has day and night because of its axis of rotation. But what about the seasons? You know, winter, spring, summer, and fall. Why does it go from hot and sunny, to breezy and chilly, to cold and snowy, to warm and rainy in many places in the world? To help explain, let's look at the difference between rotation and revolution. As you have probably already guessed, rotation is an object spinning around its own axis, like the Earth on its axis. Revolution is an object spinning around another object, like a satellite or our moon around Earth. Just as the moon revolves around the Earth, the planets revolve around the sun. Earth revolves in orbit around the sun in 365 days, 6 hours, 9 minutes, at about 29 to 30 kilometers per second. Hey, does 365 sound familiar? Yes, that's right! It's one full year! And what about those extra 6 hours and 9 minutes? Well, they add up to create an extra day every 4 years, which adds a day to February. So, how does this revolution cause the seasons? Well, let's check it out. You may have noticed throughout this video that Earth is not vertical or straight up and down. In fact, it is tilted at about 23.5 degrees. The north end of the axis is always pointed toward the North Star as the Earth revolves around the sun. This tilt, combined with its revolution around the sun, causes seasonal changes. So when you are tilted away from the sun, it is winter, because you are getting less warmth from the sun, making the temperatures colder. And when you are tilted towards the sun, you get more warmth from the sun, and the temperatures are higher, and it is summer. So, if you prefer one season, have a lot of money, like to travel, you could stay in that season all year long. But personally, I think the changing seasons are beautiful. Not only do the seasons change, but the amount of sunlight that we receive changes as well. Because our planet is tilted on its axis as it travels around the sun, different points on Earth receive more or less sunlight at different times of the year. Which is not only why it gets colder in the winter, but why we also get less sunlight in the winter. Okay, so this explains day and night and the seasons, but wait, don't go yet! Yes, yes, come back. Phew. I want to tell you about four super cool days that you can celebrate during the year. Did I say extra holidays? What are they, you say? Well, just like we name the start of a new day 12 a.m. as midnight and 12 p.m. as noon, and we name and celebrate the end of the year, New Year's Eve, and the beginning of the year, New Year's Day, well, we also name the 2 days when the sun's path in the sky is the farthest north or south from the equator. People celebrate these days all around the world. In the northern hemisphere, or top half of the Earth, where the United States is located, the summer solstice in June marks the start of summer and the longest day of the year. This is when the North Pole is tilted closest to the sun. The winter solstice in December marks the start of winter and the shortest day of the year. Do you see how the South Pole is tilted closest to the sun? Okay, so we have the summer solstice in June and the winter solstice in December. The other 2 days that we can celebrate are the 2 days when day and night are exactly the same length. These are the March equinox and the September equinox, days when the sun is exactly above the equator. Now that's a great excuse for a party! We have spun all the way to the end of today's lesson! We learned that the Earth rotates around its axis of rotation, creating day and night. The Earth revolves around the sun in 365 days, or 1 year. The Earth's tilt causes certain parts of the Earth to receive more or less sun during the year, creating seasons. In the northern hemisphere, the North Pole tilts closest to the sun on the June solstice, creating the first day of summer and the longest day of the year. The South Pole tilts closest to the sun on the December solstice, creating the first day of winter and the shortest day of the year. The March and September equinoxes are the 2 days during the year when the Earth is directly above and below the sun, meaning that day and night are exactly the same length. Hey! Don't forget to check out the engaging games and thought-provoking resources related to this lesson. And always remember, you are out of this world!